Welcome back to another episode of Taylor Cut Tutorials. I am Jordan Taylor Cut Films. That's what it says on my birth certificate. Just kidding, I don't have a birth certificate. I was raised by wolves in the jungle like Mowgli. No idea what I'm talking about. Hello? Welcome back to another episode of Taylor Cut Tutorials. I hope everyone's having a phenomenal day. I'm excited to do another tutorial here on YouTube. I've actually been releasing new tutorials. If you haven't checked them out yet, they're just on my website. It is called Intent On. Intent On. I don't know where I'm gonna add text. Maybe somewhere around here. Who knows? Yeah, on Intent On, there's 10 episodes of Taylor Cut University right now, which talk about photography, filmmaking, how to be a content creator, all that awesome stuff. I dive into color grading, my editing process, sound design, and I'm going to be continuing to upload with new episodes every month. The first month is absolutely free. You can cancel whenever you want, and you also get my photo filters and video LUTs as well. If you get a moment, check the description. The link to Intent On is on there. In on there, a lot of the same words. Also, please put in the comments what other topics you'd like me to cover, because I do want to make courses that tailor to your need. See what I did there? The word tailor, pretty solid. Also have some clothing coming out. This is a sweater that I made. I'm gonna have t-shirts and sweaters and all that fun stuff. And if you order, I'll write you a handwritten note and then have it delivered by Hedwig, an owl from Harry Potter. No, but I will write a note. Maybe one day we'll get to carrier owls. That'd be pretty dope. I'm still waiting for my invitation to Hogwarts. One of these days. Anyway, today's episode is brought to you by Storyblocks Video. I mentioned in a previous tutorial, but Storyblocks Video is where I like to go to get B-roll footage, royalty-free stock footage, After Effects templates, a lot of supplemental footage to help put the edit together. They are awesome. The link to get to Storyblocks Video is also in the description, so check them out. So for today's tutorial, I thought it would be cool to take some footage from Storyblocks Video, some B-roll, and also take some travel footage that I've already accumulated and put together kind of this combined edit. This way we could focus on the editing process and how to tell a story after you've already shot. Looking through and organizing your footage is an incredible tool. That way you can start to understand what the tone is, what pieces may be added in order to kind of finish the puzzle that you're putting together. So let's go ahead and without further ado, kind of look at this super edit that I put together, and then we can dive into Adobe Premiere and I can walk through how I put the edit together, why I made the choices that I did, different techniques for transitions, and hopefully that can be a help. I like help. I like the movie The Help. You was kind, you was smart, you was important. Kind of sounded like Forrest Gump a little bit there. Jenny taught me how to climb a shoulder, how to dangle. Sometimes there just aren't enough rocks. Awesome. So let's check out this Taylor Cut film and then we'll go ahead and dive into the edit.
Game of luck.
A real man makes his own luck, don't you? Right, Dawson?
And you find that sort of rootless existence appealing, do you?
Well, yes, ma'am, I do. I mean, got everything I need right here with me. Got air in my lungs and a few blank sheets of paper. I mean, I love waking up in the morning not knowing what's gonna happen. Who I'm gonna meet. Where I'm gonna wind up. I figure life's a gift, and I don't intend on wasting it. You never know what hand you're gonna get dealt next. You learn to take life as it comes at you. To make each day count.
Well said, Jack.
Yeah.
to making it count.
To make it count.
Be together like a clock. Take our time and make it ours. We can be something that not. We could climb a hill and look at stars. And they say stars are way too far, but I know right where you are. Keep asking how do you spend all your days by yourself, and I just said I love you till I die. Your friend, they keep asking do you want to spend all your years by yourself, and you just said. We can feel the space that's in between, hide away under the sheets. Take a day, just you and me. And we could stay up late and watch TV, but we don't have to see the screen. Just talk until we fall asleep. But all my friends, they keep asking how do you spend all your days by yourself, and I just said I love you till I die. Your friend, they keep asking do you want to spend all your years by yourself, and you just said I will never say goodbye.
Well, there you go. I hope you enjoyed that. Now let's go into the computer. That'd be cool. Just dive into the computer. Let's go ahead and go into the screen recording on the computer. Can walk through the edit a little bit, and then we can take it from there. And yeah,
When putting an edit together, pacing is incredibly important, not only for the entirety of your edit, but flowing from shot to shot as well. It should feel smooth and effortless when you're transitioning between shots. In this particular part of the edit, this is when Leonardo DiCaprio's voiceover is saying, "I never know who I'm gonna meet or where I'm gonna wind up." I thought the shot of this boy in Morocco was perfect because not only is there a character on the bike passing by in front of the frame acting as a wipe, but also I'm able to adjust the time remapping and speed here. So it starts in regular speed, 24 frames per second, and then slowly starts to slow down. Now, not only is the pacing important, but the movement between shots as well. So, since we're pushing in on the shot of the boy, the next shot following should have movement in it as well. For this shot, we are moving from left to right in this alleyway, so as you can see, it really helps blend the shots together. Color tone is incredibly important as well, because if you're going from a night scene to a day scene, or in an alleyway to a different part of the alleyway, making sure that the colors match help to blend the shots together. What I usually like to do is go in and adjust the color tone, the midtones, the shadows, the highlights, and I love giving this warm feeling like the sun is shining down. So I'll adjust the shadows, the midtones, the highlights, maybe play with the vignette, and all of this is done with the Magic Bullet Suite. Right now I'm using Colorista to adjust. You can use this in Lumetri and Adobe Premiere, whichever way you want to adjust the oranges, the reds, the blues, the purples, kind of play around and see what feels right for you. So since this is magic hour, I'm going to make the highlights nice and pink, midtones red, and the shadows green. Lastly, I'll go down to the S curves here, raise some shadows, highlights, and really make it feel like a whole scene. Now, when you don't have any dialogue, you're essentially putting together a montage, which is a series of shots, and when placed next to each other, it tells a story. So Leonardo DiCaprio's voiceover, luckily, is talking about having a book, and all he needs is air in his lungs and fresh sheet of paper. So that's why I decided to use this shot of Tuan writing in a notebook, and then I added a lens flare to help blur the two shots together. The technique moving from shot to shot is better known as transitions. So for this particular transition, I thought it'd be great to actually make it look like the painting was sketched in a notebook first, so there's a reasoning to showing it. So I added tracking marks into the notebook here of Carmela, then just digitally added it into the notebook. Now this is all amazing, but there should be a theme and a story to everything that you're doing. So for this particular video, the theme is having that sense of childhood innocence and magic, and for me, it's seeing it through the lens of my camera. Now for this shot of the kids playing soccer, I know that you'll probably be looking at their faces, so I adjust the framing of the following shot with the camera so that way the camera lines up on the rule of thirds exactly where your eyes were. Now I'm able to make these type of decisions by the process of making selects. So as you can see, I have a select sequence here where I keep all my favorite parts of the footage that I've collected in Morocco. This way, when there's a line about you never know what hand you're going to get dealt, I remember seeing a shot of a hand, and that way I can place it exactly over the lyrics. Now, what all of this does is it relays a message. For me, this whole video has to do with the one line saying, "You never know what's going to come at you. You should make every day count." And for me, nothing brings me greater joy than seeing smiles on other people's faces. This is why I love traveling. Seeing new cultures, having new experiences, and being able to relate to one another on a human level. Now, we all make videos to share the way we see the world, but to be able to send a message of happiness and love and something that resonates deep to you is the most important thing, because ultimately, what that does is creates a story. I wanted to use a speed ramp, whipping through these streets here, moving backwards, almost showing you can move backwards in time and still have that feeling like you did when you were a kid. One takes or long duration takes really help with setting a story, because what's happening on the frame is all you have to look at. Whether the shot is handheld or steady cam, moving fast or slow, it all adds energy. I knew I wanted to combine different looks within this video, and using the footage from Storyblock's video of this virtual reality really helped set a tone and add to the story. This way I was able to combine VHS effects, old film effects, and it still feel like it's in the same grounded reality. To me, having a camera and traveling the world is the same as being able to fly through space. I, being born in 1988, remember what it's like watching VHSs at home. My parents would record home videos of us, and this was our memories, this was our camera roll. So I wanted to apply this VHS filter to different shots in order to give that sense of nostalgia. When watching a movie, it is the combination of visuals and audio, and being fully immersed within the sound design is incredibly important to teleporting your audience. After I get all my visuals and colors set, the last thing I do is go in and mix the sound design. I've built up a roster of different sounds and I go ahead and search for book ripping, birds chirping, wind blowing, all these different elements that I can layer underneath one another to really make it feel like you are immersed within this world. What all of this does is sets an ambiance. Go ahead and shut your eyes and picture what it's like to be in a park. Are there birds chirping, kids laughing, leaves blowing in the wind? What I like to do is take sound recordings of the different places that I go to use and layer underneath. So for the kids laughing and dancing in the street, I take sound effects and car designs and ambiance from being in Morocco, Marrakesh, India, and all these places I've been fortunate enough to travel. Another tool popularly used is time remapping or speed ramping like we used earlier. This gives you the control to dictate how the tempo is going to unfold within the edit. I especially love using time remapping right before a beat drop. You can go ahead and ramp up the clouds right before the next shot to really add to that energy I was talking about. Another amazing tool is keyframing. What I like to do is set keyframes for both the scale and the position. That way I can add digital zoom ins and zoom outs to add this kinetic energy and push-ins on the shots. Now finally, it's about choosing shots that resonate to you. Since this is a happy piece and it's a sense of nostalgia, I had an amazing time going through old footage from my trip to Hawaii with Amir and Chelsea, and an important part to stay organized is color coding and labeling all of your footage. For this edit, I used blue for all of the night and space themed, green for all the outside and daytime, tan for all of the story blocks B-roll, and brown for the warmer tones when in Morocco and Marrakesh. Lastly, is just adding your flair onto the video. It all ties the story together with an overall motif. What I would love to be taken away from this video is how you never lose that sense of innocence. Some of us have it through singing, some of us through dancing, some of us through writing, some of us through filmmaking. And at the end of the day, just create what feels truthful for you, without the fear of judgment or expectation. And here you go. Zoomed out, this is what the final edit looks like. Save.
There you go. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. I appreciate everybody watching. Again, the link to IntentOn, where I'm releasing my Taylor K University episodes, is in the description. Click on that. I hope it can help. Free for the first month. Cancel whenever you want. And yeah, I appreciate you all for watching. Leave a comment on what type of topics you'd want me to cover. And gonna be making more videos soon. Have an amazing day. Hakuna Matata. And yes. And yes.